Okay, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum and a very good day to you all. In today's class, I talk about design of automated manufacturing system. Okay. There are six design of automated manufacturing system that I will talk to you tonight, which is among them a model-based system, a teaching factory, then a CPS system, and many there are six system lah that I'm going to discuss to you tonight. They are the model-based system and simulation-based design, okay, and then the modular design, and then the CFD-based design, the automated manufacturing system design, and teaching and learning factory design. Okay, all of these are covered in the course outcome of this subject lah, which is course outcome number 3, which must teach you about the design of automatic manufacturing system. Okay, the way that I make this lecture note is I studied about all the latest research on designs of manufacturing system, like from 10 years back lah, 2014 until 2024. Okay, so you can see in my lecture note and also in the book that I will upload after this class, all this latest research on designs. Okay, so you can see all the references, the design, the purpose, the methods, and the finding. Okay, this is how I will teach you in the class, and then I will explain to you which kind of design is suitable for which company and which typical product that those design is suitable for. Like cyber physical system is suitable for the product like CNC machine parts, complex machining parts, and to the suitable company for them are aerospace manufacturers and precision machining companies. This is what I try my best to make easy to understand, because most of the time we know about certain design, but we do not know when we should apply it, which company we should apply that design. Okay, this you come to my class, I explain to you. Okay, so we start with the first one, which is model-based design. Okay, model-based design is a sophisticated approach utilized in automated manufacturing system to enhance the design, analysis, and control of manufacturing process. Okay, it employs mathematical and simulation models to predict and optimize system performance, thus ensuring efficiency and reliability and flexibility in production. Okay, this method integrates various design tools and methodologies to streamline the development process, to reduce cost and minimize time required to bring product to market. Okay, some of the research that I mentioned here, there are more that I mentioned in my book. Okay, which I will upload the book after this lecture. There are two of them that I put in the slide. Okay, by Fantasies et al. In 2023, focus on design of cyber physical system for energy modeling and optimization of end milling machining. Design aims to automate and optimize power consumption in industrial machining process, reducing cost and emission. Integration of automated design of experiment tool set within the CPS framework significantly enhance the energy efficiency and productivity of machining operation. Okay, and Klaus in 2017 explore model-based design in context of MEMS, focusing on creating a systematic design flow for developing heterogeneous system with electromechanical and electronic component. Design approach enhance flexibility and reduce development time and cost by integrating electromechanical and electric design process. Okay, so you can see here, I put here six of the researchers related to the design of the model-based design. Okay, like Dimitros Pantastis in 2023, the design of the cyber physical system. Okay, the purpose to automate and characterize and predict power consumption industrial machining process. Okay, they use the method hidden Markov model, automated DOE tool set, CNC machining and energy feature fraction extraction. The CPS and automated DOE tool set help in selecting optimal machining parameters and tool path, significantly reducing energy consumption by 40%. Okay, so the second researcher, Jenny Klaus, Eric Schaefer, in 2017, they designed the model-based MEMS design. The purpose is to create a systematic design flow for developing heterogeneous system with electromechanical electronic component. Okay. They use the FEM simulation, Verilog A modeling, physical design tool, and co-simulation. The approach, the finding is the design approach enhance flexibility and reduce development time and cost by integrating electromechanical and electronic design process. Okay. And another researcher in 2016, Chayong Zhang, Pin Yu Jiang et al., they designed the configuration design of the add-on cyber physical system with CNC machine tool. The purpose of add-on CPS is to achieve intelligent control of production process through data-driven architecture. Okay, they're using the big data analysis, data acquisition, sensor network configuration, and CPS-oriented middleware. Okay, the finding is CPS improved the automation of CNC machine tools by enabling adaptive configuration and real-time optimization. It enhanced production efficiency, reduced operational costs. Okay. Okay, the same model design by Christian Federing, Armin Lecker in 2014. Okay, they designed the autonomous system for maintenance tasks. Okay. Requirement and design of a control architecture. The purpose is to automate maintenance tasks in key manufacturing system into transition from reactive to preventive method. Okay, the method they use analysis of operational behavior fault diagnosis method and control architecture system. The finding is enables more efficient and timely maintenance process, reducing downtime and increasing system availability. Okay, and Ni Ricardo Sandislo Grazio in 2017, they designed the robotic cell for precision assembly. The purpose is automate to the assembly procedure in aluminium deep brazing of radar antenna system, reducing execution time and improving standardization. They use the SCARA manipulator, Cartesian robot control, and visual environment simulation. Okay, the design improves assembly accuracy and reduces execution time for radar antenna system. Okay, and Dimitris Maurice John in 2020, they designed the flexible manufacturing cell. They provide generation 4.0 and engineers with enhanced skills and hands-on experience with through development of highly automated flexible manufacturing cell. Okay, they use the method they use are in vitro testing, case study analysis, collaborative group design and practical implementation, and skill assessment. The finding they find flexible manufacturing cell enables students to gain practical expertise, develop problem solving skill, and understand integration of automation in modern manufacturing system. Okay, these are the researchers lah on the model based design. Okay, so how about the company which is you may benefit from this slide lah, because in this slide I mentioned the design and the typical product and the suitable company. Okay, you work as in a company, you are better understanding what is your company is purpose for. Okay, like cyber physical system, typical product suitable for it are CNC machine parts, complex machining component. Suitable company are aerospace manufacturers and precision machining companies. Okay, model MEMS design. MEMS itself, sensor and actuator, and the suitable company are semiconductor companies, and on CPS, customized CNC parts, electric tooling system, and CNC machine tool manufacturer, custom machining services. Okay, then you can read, you can pause this slide. Later on, you can pause this slide, and you can see which product are suitable for your company. Okay, Okay, let's go for the simulation-based design. Just now we are talking about model-based design. Now we are talking about simulation-based design. It's quite the same thing, but for this we are using model. Okay, using that the same thing like simulation, they are producing model also. Okay, the design of all this thing, and then we implement on the shop floor. Okay, now we are talking about simulation based design in automation system involved using computational model to create, test and optimize manufacturing process before physical implementation. This proves the bridge various simulation methodology such as discrete event simulation, agent based modeling, computational fluid dynamic to predict system performance under different scenario. By simulating the manufacturing process, engineer can identify potential issue, optimize resource allocation, and improve overall system efficiency. Okay, the difference between the simulation and the model based design that we talked just now is the model based design is it's not that too simple, but we can draw the design with our drawing board, with our hand, using the now tablet and pen and everything. You can design and you can show to your superior, and then once they approve, they will implement this design. Okay, for the more advanced situation edit, for we using simulation based design, we are involving computers, software and everything that we simulate first, and then we propose based on our simulation result. Okay, so simulation based design offer a powerful tool for enhancing the flexibility and efficiency of automated manufacturing system. By creating virtual models of manufacturing process, it allows for thorough testing and optimization without the need for costly physical prototypes. This method supports decision making by improving insight into system behavior under various conditions, helping to optimize parameters like buffer size, material handling strategies, and production schedules. Okay, so some of the research here, like Herbs et al. 2022, focus on designing high mix or low volume manufacturing system. Okay, the research aim to optimize the profit by OSA system by designing effective buffer allocation and material handling a system to address challenges in product variety and dynamic demand. The simulation based design lead to 10 to 30% improvement in efficiency. Okay, they support better buffer management. Okay, another research by Herbs Dang Matagan 2022 collaborates the result observed in earlier research by Maurice Dokers 2014, who explored the design and planning of manufacturing network for mass customization in achieving enhanced performance. Okay, so we see some of the research here. I put six of them. There are many more which you can find in my book. Okay, so Cohen Herbs Quang Van Vindang in 2022, they designed the simulation-based automated high-mix, low-volume manufacturing system. The purpose is to optimize the profit of high-mix, low-volume manufacturing system by designing effective buffer allocation. Okay. Now, when we have buffer, we can adjust and we can manage the product lah, because we have buffer. Okay. The method they use are discrete event modeling, agent-based modeling, simulated annealing, reduced variable, neighborhood research. Okay. Finding they managed to go for 30% improvement in efficiency. Okay. Okay, Ricky Pakkani et al. In 2021, they designed the CFD-based through flow method. The purpose is to predict of design performance of gas turbines efficiently, addressing the need for reliable transient behavior prediction under varying operating condition. Okay, method they used CFD, through flow model, asymmetric Euler equation, and entropy distribution. The CFD based through flow method offers accurate of design performance prediction with significantly reduced operational times. Okay, it enables detailed and reliable simulation to make available tool for gas turbine design. Okay, then Maltese and Dukas in 2014, they designed the manufacturing network for mass customization. The purpose is to address challenge in designing and planning manufacturing system for mass customization. The method they use are dynamic configuration and optimal routing of manufacturing network. And the finding they have enhanced performance in terms of cost, time, and complexity. Okay. And now we go to the next slide. Okay. Edgar and Tamayo, Yasser Imtiaz Khan in 2018, they designed the control panel of automated modular construction. The purpose is to develop a systematic and iterative design methodology for control panels. Okay. The method they use are integrated function modeling, automated or axiomatic design and design structure, net metric, and findings are improved layout and wiring of control panel, facilitating computer-aided design implementation. Dahyan et al. In 2020, they designed the FMS, Flexible Manufacturing System. The purpose is to enhance flexibility and intelligent coordination and efficient handling and quality control in railcar sub-assembly. They use Analogic 8.2.3 software. Okay, this is among the software that maybe if you can remember the last week I mentioned about this software. Okay, finding is FMS design demonstrated suitability for performing assembly and quality assurance operation with minimal interruption and human intervention. Okay, and Bashir Salah Omar Jani in 2017. They designed the wire driven SRM, but it's a sticker crane robot lah. Okay, sticker crane robot. Okay, they introduced that sticker crane design using wire driven robot, aiming to overcome mechanical limitation and enhance performance. The method they use are simulation based validation comparison with Cartesian SRM. Okay, wire-driven SRM reduces cycle time and more suitable for tall building compared to Cartesian SRM. Okay, so these are the typical products and suitable company for it. Okay, for example, autonomous system for maintenance tasks. So typical product are maintenance system, automatic diagnostic tool, suitable company for automotive manufacturers and large-scale industrial plants. Okay, and then automatic optical inspection, AOI support frame. Okay, typical product are high-speed inspection system of optical component. The suitable company are electronics manufacturers, quality control and service provider. And then last one is PetriNet based dynamic scheduling. Typical product are dynamic production schedules and optimized resource allocation. And suitable company are FMS system providers and automotive manufacturers. Okay, that's number two. We go for the number three is modular design. Okay, modular design. What is modular design? Modular design is an automated manufacturing system involved the use of standardized intangible modules that can easily configure and reconfigure to meet varying production needs. This approach provides a high degree of flexibility, allowing for quick adjustment to production lines, easier maintenance, and straightforward upgrades. Okay. By integrating modular components, manufacturers can streamline assembly process, reduce lead time and everything. Okay, so modular design is, you can imagine the furniture in your home, in your houses, where you can adjust for your need. You assembly back the furniture at your home. Okay, the same goes to the modular design. When we have all the machines, we assemble in various way, okay, to meet our needs. Okay, and then when we have another order, another requirement, a new requirement for the new product, we adjust everything, we rearrange everything to suit for the new demand. Okay, that is the modular design. Okay, so we can see some research of it. Okay, adoption of modular design in manufacturing become increasingly essential due to the growing demand for customization and need for rapid product changes. Okay, because nowadays product are keep on changing. We can see our handphone. Okay, we can see our handset, handphone, and all. It keep on changing after it launching, and then after a while, after that, our phone will become not new phone anymore. There are new design and new product and new features of new phone, like that. Okay, so I give example of a phone because we use phone every day. Okay, so we can see the design. Sometimes we spend a lot of money to buy some certain phone, and then after a while, our phone will become not new anymore because there are new product, new features on another design, another new product of phones. Again, so how can they fastly design new phone? Because they had the modular design. Okay, so prominent study Salonitis 2014 is probably benefit of modular design assembly automation, and this study aligned with finding by Ghana and Lee 2022, who applied modular design to streamline and configuration of modular housing layout. Okay, demonstrating significant reduction in design time and cost. Okay, so we are talking also about modular design housing. Okay, because nowadays we can see house in the cabin, you know, in the cabin. Okay, it apa, it is a modular design. Okay, we can also we can be applied into the housing department also. Okay, so you can see here by Constantinos 2014, they designed the modular design. Okay, the purpose is to address the need for a higher number of product variants and to allow a higher degree of automation. Okay, so method they use are design structure metric, modular function deployment, MFD, house of quality, and single minute action of dice. Okay, modular design, the finding is modular design lead to average reduction of components for variant by about 20%, with 35% of part being common to all variants. Okay, so Dimitris Mortis, they are designing the flexible managing cell for new engineers. Okay, I have mentioned about this before. Pedram Ganat Yong Lee in 2022, they are designing the automated modular housing design. Okay, to streamline the modular housing and design process by automating module configuration. This address iterative, time consuming, and costly nature of traditional modular housing design. Okay, which often fails to meet product and functional requirements efficiently. They use the couple generative adversarial network, Kogan, and module configuration algorithm. Okay, the finding they have design enhances the generative design of modular housing, making it possible for to generate feasible and optimal modular housing layout automatically. Okay, it will help the architect and stakeholders. Okay, to design the houses fastly. Okay, Johannes Uglert in 2016, they designed the reconfigurable cellular manufacturing system. Okay, the purpose is to offer flexibility in manufacturing to adapt the to fluctuating customer demand and uncertain business environment. By rearranging modular system resource and organization can balance system capabilities. Okay, they use the computational design synthesis, and the finding is RCMS. Okay, helps automate the design and analysis of system configuration, allowing decision maker to evaluate cost, utilization, and lead time of various design. Okay, Luca Gualtieri, Erwin Rausch in design the human robot collaborative assembly. The purpose is to improve the safety, ergonomics, and efficiency in human robot collaborative assembly lines by developing design guideline. Okay, the method they use are ergonomic assessment, safety analysis, and simulation. The finding lead to safer and more efficient line, as enhancing worker safety and comfort. And Guilino Rosati, Simon Mento, Fabio, 2017, they designed the aperture variable aperture gripper. Okay, to create cost-effective flexible gripper and gripper the hand, hand gripper. Okay, capable to adapting its aperture to different handling demand. Okay, they use the method simulation, preliminary test, design optimization, mechanism synthesis, and prototyping. The finding are variable aperture gripper allow for increased flexibility in automated assembly system. Okay, so these are the some of the products and suitable company of for bid. Okay, some I have mentioned before. Okay, I mentioned the new ones. Modular design for increasing assembly automation. Typical product are furniture, customer electronics, customer automotive or components. Suitable company are furniture manufacturers, electronics companies, automotive suppliers. And then the RCMS. Typical product are customized machinery, adaptable production system. Suitable company are industrial equipment manufacturers, flexible production service provider. And robot collaborative assembly, typical product dia, assembly line components, ergonomic workstation. Suitable company are automotive manufacturers, electronics and assembly plant. Okay. Okay. So we go for the number four. Okay. The CFD-based design. Okay. CFD stand for computational fluid dynamic. Okay. To analyze and optimize fluid flow and thermal process building various manufacturing components and system, this approach enables detailed simulation of fluid interaction, heat transfer and other physical phenomena, providing insight that guide to development of more efficient and more effective manufacturing process. Okay, by using CFD, the engineers can predict system behavior under different conditions, optimize design parameters and enhance overall performance. Okay, so some of the research using CFD by Ricky et al. Demonstrate the application of CFD based through flow method to predict of design performance of gas turbine. Okay, and then research by Tabakel et al. 2022, it used to optimize thermal performance and reduce system volume and weight. Okay, we can see the some of the research here by Ricky Pakiani Marceloni in 2021. The design of CFD based through flow method to predict of design performance of gas turbine, efficiently addressing the need for reliable transient behavior prediction. They use the CFD through flow model, asymmetric and elongation and entropy distribution. Okay, a CFD through flow method offers of design performance prediction, which significantly reduce computational time. Okay, number two is James Tambakel by Vikram Outer in 2022. They designed the shape optimized non-round table tube and heat exchanger to design heat exchanger with performance and reduced volume and weight. Okay, they use multi-scale, multi-physics analysis, automated CFD and FEA simulation. Okay, or approximation assisted optimization and experimental validation. Okay, the finding they successfully produce heat exchanger with 20% reduction of air side pressure drop and core envelope volume. Okay. Hu Liu Zhen, 2020, they use PetriNet dynamic scheduling to improve scheduling efficiency in the flexible management system by using deep reinforcement learning and graph computational network. Okay. The approach aims to optimize scheduling of tasks and resource. Okay. They use the PetriNet deep reinforcement learning graph computational network CGN. Okay, the PetriNet based dynamic scheduling design helps in automation by providing a robust and adaptive scheduling mechanism for flexible manufacturing system. Okay, we can see another research by Tambakel Vikram in 2022. They designed a multi-scale and multi-physics analysis to optimize and design the performance of heat exchangers. Okay, the method they use are CFD, FEA and optimization algorithm. The finding are optimized heat exchangers deliver similar thermal performance to traditional design but significant reduction in side pressure drop. Okay, Ding Togen et al. In 2021, they designed the digital twin for cyber physical system. The purpose is to create virtual presentation of physical asset, process and system to enable real-time monitoring, simulation and optimization. The method they use are comprehensive survey analysis of current technologies, case study on digital twin application. The finding digital twin design helps in automation by providing a real-time data-driven virtual representation of physical system. Yeah. And Gabriel Pesetti, Moniza, and Erwin, they designed the parametric and generative design technique. The purpose is to implement mass customization in the building industry using parametric and generative design technique. Method they use are parametric modeling, generative design, case study on glued laminated timber. Okay. Finding they what they finding approach facilitates mass production of building industry, allowing efficient production of customized components. Okay. And these are the industry that are related like the shape optimized non-round tube heat exchanger. Typical product are heat exchangers and cooling system. Suitable company are the aircon company and automated supplier. Digital twin design is for typical product are digital model of manufacturing system, real-time monitoring solution. Suitable company are industrial automation companies, smart manufacturing solution. Okay. Then AGV, AGV system, logistic solution, and warehouse company are warehouse automation companies and logistic providers. Okay. Number five, bear with me, and there will be another one, and then finish lecture. Okay. So, automated manufacturing system leverage advanced technologies to streamline and optimize manufacturing process. They use components like robotic arms, CNC machine, conveyor belts, and computer control system to achieve high efficiency. Okay. They, we want to minimize the human intervention, reduce production error, and overall increase productivity, and automating repetitive and complex tasks. Okay. So there will be still human involvement, but reduced. Okay. Research on automated manufacturing system. Okay. By Patazis et al. 2023, improve system energy efficiency and productivity in manufacturing operation. And by Herbs 2022, simulation based automated high mixed volume, low volume system. Okay. So these are the some of them. Okay. By Combs, Herbs et al. In 2022, simulation of based of automated high mixed low volume manufacturing system. The purpose is to optimize the profit of high mix low volume manufacturing system by designing effective buffer allocation. Okay, the method they use are discrete event modeling, agent based modeling, simulated annealing, and reduced variable neighborhood search. The finding is they manage to do the 30% efficiency improvement. Okay, Kars Marsik, Boston in 2018. They designed the industrial 4.0 test bed for self-acting barman. The purpose is to demonstrate and verify the principles of industry 4.0 through practical application in the form of automated barman. Design aims to provide a comprehensive understanding of industry 4.0, focusing on modularity. Methods they use are analysis of manufacturing procedure, hardware and manufacturing structuring, modularity and demonstration, and real-time data processing. Finding the test bed effectively demonstrate industry 4.0 principle, providing a practical educational tool that showcases the integration of and optimization of manufacturing process. And Carsten Silber, Markel Albers in 2021, they designed the automated 2D layout design. The purpose is to transform conceptual assembly line layout to into physical ones automatically. Okay. This is necessary to improve efficiency and reduce the manual effort required on planning phases. Okay. The method they use are physically phase modeling and Newton's law of motion and generating algorithm. Okay. Findings are designed to help in automating the layout planning or assembly system, reducing manual intervention and ensuring optimal spatial arrangement of resource. Okay. And then the Dimitris, okay. I have covered about Dimitris. Now, Ivaro M. Sampio, Andre Lima et al. In 2023, they designed the automated automating optical inspection support frame. Okay, to improve performance and facility by reducing width and number of components, the goal is to enhance robustness and stability of AOI system during high-speed operation. They use the generative design, additive manufacturing, selective laser sintering, CAD modeling and experimental testing. Finding redesign AOI support frame reduced overall weight and number of components, enhancing stability and performance. Okay. These are the companies, these are the typical product like Industry 4.0 test bed, self-acting Batman, Barman. Okay. Typical product modular automation component, Industry 4.0 educational tools, and suitable company manufacturing resources center and educational institution. Okay. And then the automated 2D layout design. Okay, typical product assembly line layout, manufacturing facility plans. Suitable company manufacturing plant engineers, assembly line planners. Okay. Okay. Now we go for the last one, which is teaching and learning factory design. Okay. The teaching and learning factory design in automated manufacturing system involve creating an educational environment that integrates advanced manufacturing technology and practice. This design aims to provide students with hands-on experience and practical skills related to modern manufacturing process. The focus is to incorporating technologies like robotics, additional additive manufacturing, and industrial Internet of Things. Okay. This teaching factory, some universities have it. Our university also have this teaching factory that we tend to teach our future engineers about certain design. Okay, hopefully when they go to the industry, they will only have to do minimal training to refresh their memories or what they have learned in during their study time. Okay, this is what the aim of the teaching factory lah. Okay, the teaching and learning factory plays a critical role in the bridging the gap between theoretical knowledge and practical application in manufacturing education. Okay, Louis Low and Quintis Deacon 2020 developed a semi-automated robotic cell design to teach Industry 4.0 technology through problem-based learning. This approach allows students to gain practical experience with key technology, fostering both technical demand and skills for modern manufacturing system. Okay, Haldor and Anderson et al. 2023 focus on smart layout design for reconfigurable manufacturing system, RMS, emphasizing the need for flexibility and quick adaptation to market changes. This design demonstrates how manufacturing system can quickly reconfigure to meet varying production demand. Okay, so about teaching, my comment is we have to alert with the changes of the technology used by us and technology used by our junior, like gap in generation and our generation gap, meaning that during my batch of study, we have the physical product that we can play around with our hand. Okay, now your batch and your future younger person than you, they are like we see our niece and our cousins and our small kids, they play handphone. Okay, they play smartphone and everything. We can expect future generation 10 years in the future, 20 years in the future, they more understand about how to use the smartphone application lah. Meaning that we can expect in the future, most of our product will become touchpad like that. This is called like the generation gap. Okay, our batch is different with the future batch and how we can adapt to this situation. This is what we have to think. Okay, so this is among the researchers of it. Okay, like Louis Low and Quintis, they designed the semi-automatic robotic cell design to develop hard technological skill related to Industry 4.0 and soft skills such as creativity and problem solving in student. The method they use are problems-based learning, integration of robots and additive manufacturing. The finding are designed to help by allowing students to gain practical experience with key technology. Okay, Halno Anderson in 2023 they design the smart layout for the RMS, which is reconfigurable manufacturing system, to handle product variety and customization. Okay, they use the digital twin simulation and advanced robotic and AI optimization. The design automates the layout process, reducing human labor and improving efficiency. Okay, Oliver Avram, Anna Valente in 2016, they designed the trajectory planning for reconfigurable robots to improve the precision and efficiency of the robot in high precision manufacturing. Okay, the method they use trajectory planning algorithm, simulation and optimization technique. The finding the design enhanced robotic precision and operational efficiency. Okay, Hu Liu Wang et al. 2020, Patrinet based dynamic scheduling. Design is dynamic scheduling design. Purpose is to enhance efficiency of flexible manufacturing system by optimizing dynamic scheduling using advanced algorithm. The method they use are deep reinforcement learning, graph convolutional network, and Patrinet, and finding to improve the responsiveness and reliability of manufacturing system by leveraging AI-based dynamic scheduling. Okay. And then Anand Mittal, Nico Siltava Tala, okay, in 2019, they designed the web-based capability matchmaking design to facilitate rapid and autonomous reconfiguration of production system. The root cause is the need for quick adaptation in dynamic manufacturing environment. Method they use are capability matching algorithm, RESTful web services, and formal information model. The finding accelerate the design and reconfiguration process, enhancing flexibility. Okay. Paul Hessler, Sacha Dominic, in 2018, they designed PP-based mold design for foam parts. Okay. Purpose to eliminate the use of release agent. They use the DRIS methodology, laser optimal release agent system, and cooperatively operating coating robot. The finding design significantly reduce and eliminates the need for release agent. Okay, Amanat Urrahman, Mazia Tuzura Zahura in 2014, they designed the rotary type automated water sprinkler to minimize water wastage and enhance water distribution. Okay, the method they use are field survey, quality function deployment, and standard engineering methods. Okay, finding design reduces water wastage, increase watering efficiency. Okay. And then these are the typical product like web-based capability matchmaking design. Typical product rapid system reconfiguration tools, additive manufacturing system, and suitable company manufacturing software developers, industrial automation firm. Okay. And then resource optimized design, resource efficient product, sustainable manufacturing design, and suitable company, sustainable product developer, environmental engineering firm. Okay, that's all for the slide. You understand or not? Okay, after this class, I will upload my ebook that I create for this class. Okay, then hope you will benefit because there are more information in that ebook in my slide. Okay, you can access it in the Google Classroom. Okay, you can get the book in the Google Classroom after this. Okay, do you have question?
No, doctor.
Okay, I hope you can benefit from my lecture. You can pause when I upload it in the YouTube. You can pause, you can read the ebook in the slide in the YouTube and also in the ebook lah. Okay, I think that's all. I will stop the recording and wait for a while. I will discuss about the mini project. Okay.